The Living BioFoundry is a platform designed to create new polymer-based materials. The concept of the Living BioFoundry is to harness synthetic biology as a source for new inputs into polymerization schemes. The advantage here is to utilize cell-based production and genetic engineering to synthesize new sets of building blocks in sufficient quantity that they can be shared downstream with polymer chemists, who can then polymerize the molecules to generate a new material. The opportunity space for synthetic biology is huge. Our goal is to capitalize on the rapidly developing capabilities in synthetic biology to create improved polymer materials. We are using the power that biological systems have to manipulate chemistry in order to make novel monomers. These monomers, or even mixtures of monomers, can be used in polymerization reactions to make materials with enhanced or completely new material properties, like biocompatible surgical materials with novel antibiotic properties, or plastics that are now designed to degrade. The idea of using synthetic biology to access new sets of molecules is powered by genetic engineering and programmability, which allows us to make all sorts of different genetic constructs in a high-throughput way to produce a rationally designed set of molecules or to screen a large library of experimental molecules we want to test. In this case, for example, that could mean changing or replacing the enzymes in a pathway, so the pathway now produces a different biomolecule. It could be altering the enzymes themselves so that they could make a different product altogether. It could be combining two unrelated biosynthetic pathways to just add the right modification to a biomolecule so that it can then be polymerized by the chemist in an ideal way. How are we doing it? We're doing it by engaging in a robust design, build, test, learn cycle with our partner facilities inside the BioPACIFIC Materials Innovation Platform to accelerate the material discovery and development process. That's the really big idea of what we're doing here at the Living BioFoundry. This system in our lab was originally designed for what is called heterologous expression. At its basic level, that means taking DNA or genetic code out of one organism and rewriting some of it so that it can be executed or expressed in a new organism. That could mean expressing an enzyme that originally came from an exotic fungus or a plant, but putting it into a bacteria or a yeast to modify the molecule or to produce more of a molecule that's hard to get. So we're taking a bioproduct from the natural world or a novel biosynthetic pathway that someone just designed and actually encoding it into an organism that can make it in high enough quantities to then be purified, extracted, and used for this polymer chemistry that we're talking about. While originally modeled after heterologous expression systems, our automation suite has been expanded to perform a large set of standard genetic and molecular biology protocols. These allow us to assemble and bring into action the DNA that we need to produce our desired product in the optimal production organism. Then we harvest and purify the molecules and transfer them to other polymer chemistry platforms to turn these biochemicals into new materials. From the beginning, we have been blessed with a lot of success. Our first wind-up project made 20 compounds, and one of them was successfully polymerized, allowing the research group to move on to scaling its production and starting to test the properties of the new material, in this case, antibiotic properties. Our system, even as we are scaling up to our full high-throughput operating capability, has demonstrated that it can hit the ball out of the park. We expect that the total number of home runs, or winning materials in our case, will go up with the number of at-bat opportunities. And the robots will let us swing the equivalent of 100 at-bats per microplate, giving us up to 1 million at-bats for a particularly large project. With the big picture concept we described hanging over us, realizing our first success was very exciting. We literally came in at a blank starting point, began bringing the automation systems online, and succeeded even at a testing scale. Since our team executed this through automation and code, it gives us a base level of functionality that is continuously improving. This lowers the barrier for the next turn of the design, build, test, learn cycle for this project, and for new projects coming down the pipeline that haven't even started. This is how we are utilizing robots and automation to increase productivity and to accomplish the bigger goal of generating new materials. With an expanded ability to produce materials, it is also important to have a way of identifying and measuring the amount of these novel compounds. To meet this need, CNSI supplemented our facility with an automation-compatible, ultra-high-performance liquid chromatography system coupled to a triple-quad mass spectrometer. This is a workhorse analysis tool used in industries from aerospace to drug testing, as well as, of course, in polymer science. This tool isolates and quantifies each molecule and can process 400 samples with one human touch. With this setup, we can test exactly how productive a genetically engineered pathway is, or know if we've successfully transferred production of a new molecule into our organism of choice. So with that said, all of this at its fundamental level entails implementing a lot of lab-based protocols, traditionally done on a benchtop, but now in an automated environment. We're taking protocols established over decades, optimized for a lab bench with human-sized tubes and dishes, but now implementing them in microplates and revamping the recipes for robotic execution. It's not trivial, but it's important work to harness the opportunities that automation can provide for us. In closing, reorganizing materials development with a design-build-test-learn cycle paradigm that can operate at scale requires continuous growth, adaptation, and building on what we have already accomplished in the Living Biofoundry. But this approach will deliver an acceleration in the creation of materials needed for the future.